Hey guys, so we are here to show you what it was like to start our lives at MIT Institute of Design.
So first we had the customary induction ceremony. So it's happy to know that we're the 11th batch of MIT RD. We're also the first batch of MIT Art, Design and Technology University.
Welcome you all. On behalf of all the existing students, faculty, management, staff, and everyone who is associated with MIRE's MIT group of institutes.
Overall, 351 students, including fashion, UG and PG. So many new faces and so many new names.
So after the introductory session, we were split into 15 groups and we were introduced to the first course, Design Overview, which was all about going to Pune and exploring what Pune was all about.
As per the briefing, we were not to use private means of transport, which left us with no other option than buses, tum-tums and rickshaws.
It is no picnic travelling in these rusty old buses and noisy rickshaws. But I think most of us did have fun. Some of us even befriended a few rickshawwalas.
When we got there, we preferred moving around on foot. That way, we could register more and get a good feel of the place.
So we are here to do some research.
So I'd say that the most important objective of this course was to get to know each other and make new friends.
Yeah, but obviously that was not all. We had to observe and study the vertical and horizontal timelines of the chalk that was given to us.
It took quite a bit of planning and communication in order to run things smoothly.
So what we are doing is basically walking up to people and then speaking to them.
There's so much history here and it was all in lush green and how like little shops started coming, then people flooded, then the flyovers.
There was a sarpanch who stopped us in the middle of the road and took us to his adda kind of chai stall and told us so much about Magarpatta.
Some people do cooperate, others have no idea about what is happening in the city. They are just concerned about their own shops.
I like that they appreciate that we as designers are going to their shops and asking them questions.
Can you tell us how old is your place?
I have been here since 25 years.
The locals were really proud of their history. They weren't holding anything back and it seemed like they had stories to tell.
It was very amusing talking to the people. Most people were very enthusiastic, but others were skeptical.
The first interviews gave us a very good idea of the life and the culture around the chalk, based on which we could investigate further. It was like playing detective, but officially.
It was quite an adventure.
All the people are working and educated. There's a constant movement throughout the day.
I was holding camera and everybody's like, Didi, hum camera mein aaye, hum camera mein aaye. I was feeling like hero. But at the same time, we also felt bad when we went to the slum. We were actually feeling so touched by the condition in which they live. And still they're so happy and energized to give interviews.
In the morning, what we saw was that there were many school children that were going and coming. While in the evening-ish, it changed and there was a lot of traffic coming up.
Most places had seen a significant amount of transformations in the past 10 to 20 years. We could see that in the people's attitudes as well.
Pure residential areas, offices, flyovers, roads, pure infrastructure, pura badal gaya within 5 to 6 years.
This place is kind of crowded. It is a marketplace. This is a big contrast we see that there are malls and street shopping in the same place.
New structures are coming up and the traffic is increasing and some people are really happy about the place, like the way it's turning out, the way it's developing.
But we talked to a rickshawwala and he said that it's getting polluted, so it's better that people again come to bicycles.
Unlike Mumbai, the travelling over here is not that easy, but for the past many years, Swargate as such has adapted really quickly.
No matter how much we may say that the area has progressed, but the traditions and the cultures are still very evident in the entire area, in the by lanes, in the people, in the temples around.
Arey, food! We got to go to some famous places in Pune and eat proper Maharashtrian street food.
Samosa, misal, vada pav, chai. These were some of the things we really did look forward to. And even the locals seemed to enjoy these foods as much as we did.
we got to see how the daily life of the locals and their routines were built around food.
There is a lot of smells and people are coming to the same stall 30 or 40 years for the buying of vegetables and different stuff. There is a fish market out there.
The local food over here, all the thelas are very nice. They give all tasty foods and all. And they're cheap and they taste very nice and they're hygienic too.
The food here is like a go-to food. Like people over here are always in a hurry. So it is something that will give them a boost of energy, whereas it is really quick, like something like a banana or a vada pav.
We see a contrast in everywhere in this place. There's some bhelwala selling bhel, and also you see a cafe in opposite to that.
We smelled a lot of different things, so we really enjoyed it. Like, we didn't want to come back early, so from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. we were there.
Each team comprised of students from different age groups, educational backgrounds, languages and cultures.
Despite that, everyone was cooperative, focused and quite efficient.
In a group, we are showing each and everyone's strength and each and everyone's contribution is really important.
All the different perspectives, be it age or the stream, actually helped us come up with a variety of content.
We I think gelled really well. We made a WhatsApp group where we can communicate with each other.
Actually, we had roles assigned to every team member. So one of the team members had to click photographs. One of them had to interview.
So each group studied very well each landmark, the architecture, the local traditions, the type of people and the clothing, the fashion. And this way we got like this holistic approach and we went in depth to everything.
So in the end, each team had to make a video for their final display.
For that, we are making various doodles, stop motion animation, and you know, like paper cutouts and all things.
So we are making a stop motion video about the people and about the vertical and the horizontal timeline, what people do from morning to the evening, and then what happen, the events that happen from Jan to December.
I saw cool tattoos. Pretty modern for a sari wearing lady, yaar.
Yeah, it's a part of our culture here.
Some teams decided to perform a street play or compose an anthem to complement their video.
आप लोग का आने का time बहुत सही है. अभी वहीं से गणपति का टोली आ रहा है. More.
MIT से हम चलने जो लगे अतरज चौक पर एक प्रोजेक्ट करने लगे ना 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 ना
कुम कुम कुमते घर named after अभी कुमते घर parallel to Lakshmi Road कुम कुम कुमते घर.
Since we were in groups, we get to know each other better. We came in, you know, as strangers and now we quite know each other.
This is the great activity that MITF provided us to gel with everybody.
Because of this, we actually travel locally. We learn about the place. We pay attention to the minute details.
All in all, it was really a way of experiential learning that the institute has put us through.
Overall, we got to know the place we are going to spend our next 4 years in.
The rural and urban life, the language, the culture.
Besides, it was good to work in groups, and we made new friends.